to ask God's blessing upon our time together, and we're going to praise the Lord. Father God, we thank you that we can come into your presence with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise today, Father. We thank you, Lord God, that we can celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ today. We thank you, Lord God, for your presence in this place. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, let's sing.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, have the mountains in reply, echo back their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Divine, oh, night.
Faithful. You're the faithful ones. You're here today to give the Lord praise.
Oh, come,
all ye faithful.
Say happy birthday to Jesus.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Well, before you sit down, go around and bless each other in Jesus' name.
good to see you.
Yeah, I wanted to. Where you at? What are you going to be talking about today?
Just a short person.
Just a short person.
Yeah, we got all the. Everybody stays in for the kids and everybody stays in.
Okay, staying in. I got it.
Praise the Lord.
Holy.
Well, it's wonderful to see each and every one of you here as we are celebrating the greatest event in history. Amen. And that's the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because if there hadn't been a birth, there wouldn't have been a crucifixion. There wouldn't have been a resurrection. And we'd be up the creek. So praise God. Amen. Well, before we begin the program with our kids, we are going to receive our morning tithes and offerings. And so I'm going to ask our ushers if you would make available the envelopes. If you're giving by cash, we encourage you to use an envelope. Fill it out for us. If you're giving your check, make it out to RCC, or you can spell it out, Redlands Christian Center. And I just want to say we appreciate all of your faithful giving. You know, we wouldn't have the opportunity to preach the Word of God, to train the children, to be a light in a dark world, in a very troubled world, if it wasn't for your financial giving. So we thank you for that. Praise God. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to give in the work of the ministry. And Father God, we know that you are for us and not against us. And Lord, that you've even promised to us, if we give, it shall be given to us. And so, Lord, we sow seeds of love and faith. We thank you for providing and meeting every need. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. Ushers, go ahead and receive. Just a reminder, there will not be prayer meeting tonight, and Bible studies on Wednesday mornings will resume in 2016. Gosh, can you believe it? 2016. We are having midweek service this Wednesday, so come join us at 6:30 on Wednesday. And so I think that's it for announcements. So I'm going to turn it over to Pastor Tara, and we're going to have our children's program. Praise God. Here you go, honey.
Good morning. Are you guys ready? Are you guys ready? Okay. All right. So I want all of my munchkins to stand up. Make sure your costumes are ready. Take one last look. Have your parents look at you one last time. Make sure you look picture perfect. Is everybody ready? Okay. All right. Head to the back. All right. And our bells. Our girls are going to get you your bells. Baby Jesus has got to move. Does everybody have their bells? Pretend you're not hearing me, okay, parents? Yeah. Am I too close?
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open
The Little Drummer Boy Play, written and directed by Miss Becky O'Bannon. On a mountain next to a little town of Bethlehem lived a little shepherd boy named Elijah, who lived with his mother and his father. He helped his dad raise the sheep. His family owned one side of the mountain where the grass was always green, and there were fresh, clean streams for the sheep to drink the water and to eat the grass. The sheep were always healthy and clean. When Elijah was out in the field with the sheep, he would play his drum that he had gotten for his birthday a year ago. And when he played, the sheep danced, the birds chirped, and all the other little animals in the field moved to the sound of the music. And even the angels in heaven danced, and the Lord God loved his music. On the other side of the mountain, the grass was a lot drier, and it had less water, and sometimes it was very windy. The sheep on that side would get dirty and dusty, and they were not as healthy. There was also a family with two boys that lived on that side of the mountain. Those two boys were jealous of Elijah's family and their herd of sheep because of the men of the town would come and buy Elijah's family's sheep. One day, those boys from the other side of the mountain found out that Elijah's daddy was sick. They made a plan to scare away the sheep and destroy Elijah's drum. They found Elijah, and they pushed him down. And they broke his drum. And they scared away the sheep. Elijah was sad and began to cry because he did not know how to tell his dad that the sheep were gone and his drum was broken. So he cried and he cried because he was so upset. Lo and behold, an angel appeared before him. And she said, "Do not cry, Elijah. For your Lord God loves your music so much because you made the angels and the animals dance. Your Lord God wants you to write a song so that everyone on earth and in the heavens can hear your music to know that his son is to be born in Bethlehem. So here is a new drum," she said. Elijah says thank you to the angel as he wipes his tears and walks down the mountain with his new drum, thinking of a new song to play for the Lord's son. Elijah goes home, and a week goes by while he is working on the song, and he goes back up the mountain. Hold on. There you go. He goes back up the mountain, and when the angel appears before him again and tells him that the baby will be born within 3 days in a manger at Jeremiah's inn, all of a sudden, it comes to Elijah, and he starts playing, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum.
Sure.
our king set? All right. Okay, walk slowly, walk slowly. Go ahead, three kings. Okay. We've got our drummer boy. Okay. And audience, you can sing along on this one too.
Gifts we bring, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum.
Could stay together. We're going to take one big group picture. Come in, come here, come here. Parents, if you want to come in, come stand behind me. Take a big picture. All the kids. Does Alexander want to be in the picture? Come here, Alexander. Go stand up there, guys, so I can get a picture of you. Landon, you want to come take a picture? No? Okay. Great job. Okay, go sit back down with your parents. Go sit back down. Go sit back down. Go sit back down. Yes, you can. You can take that off. Yes. And I would like to also. I don't have. If I could just for 1 second, if I could have Miss Becky wave to everyone. Miss Becky wrote and directed our play, so let's give Miss Becky a big round of applause. Great job, Miss Becky.
Well, it's always special when the kids get up on the stage. You just don't know exactly what's going to happen. Yeah, they did a great job. Thank you so much. Sharing some of the story about the birth of our Lord. I thought I would just take a few minutes and share the story from the scripture. I'll be reading out of Luke's gospel. No, it's okay. Thank you. Out of chapter 1 of Luke, verse number 26, and I'm going to change microphones. This one's having a problem. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in to her and said, "Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women." And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, "Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God, and behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end." Then said Mary unto the angel, "How shall this be, seeing I know not a man?" And the angel answered and said unto her, "The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. Of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For with God nothing shall be impossible. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Now we're going to fast forward about 9 months. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria, and all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, unto Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. I said all people. Amen. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, you shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards man. And it shall come to pass, and it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us go now, even unto Bethlehem, and see this which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in the manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept these things in her heart, pondering them. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. Praise God. What I just read to you was not a nighttime story, a fiction, or a fable. This happened some 2,000 years ago. God took on flesh. And as the angel declared to those shepherds, he came to be a Savior for all men. What's a Savior? Someone that saves. Did you know that the name Jesus means God saves? There's saving in his name. Well, we know there's healing in his name. There's deliverance in his name. But my friends, we have to realize that we need a Savior. The Bible declares that all of us are born into this world, born into sin because of Adam's original sin. And because of that, the world needed a Savior. That's why God sent his Son. He was born there in Bethlehem in that stable. But he grew up, and some 33 years later, after living a sinless life, he went to the cross to be that sacrifice for sin. So that all people, as Scripture says, could receive a Savior. You know, I've been a minister a long time, been a part of the church a long time. I've shared the gospel with people, and at times it's like it goes right over their head. Why does it go over their head? Because they don't realize they need a Savior. Only God can really open our eyes to realize that we need a Savior. But God doesn't force that on people. When people begin to search the meaning of life, search why am I here, search about thinking about eternity, what's going to happen after I die, it's at that point that people's hearts begin to open and God is able to shed some light in there that you and I need a Savior. You might say, well, what do I do about this Savior? The Bible says, if you and I call upon the name of the Lord, we shall be saved. Once you realize that you're lost and without hope and without God, and that God provided a Savior, you can draw near to Him and ask Him to come live in your life. The Bible says, if you believe that Jesus is the Christ and confess His Lordship in your life, you shall be saved. So I hope today at this Christmas service that you have either already received this Savior or that you're deciding to do that today. What a better day than to receive Jesus than at a Christmas service. So before we close, I'm going to give you an opportunity, and those that are watching by the internet, we're streaming live all over the world right now. And you can actually go to YouTube and see this whole service, see the kids in the performance. You're welcome to do that. We encourage you to. But I have to ask you, have you received this Savior that came? If you haven't, pray this prayer. Believe that God is hearing your prayer. Receive the Savior today. Those of you that have already received the Savior, just pray in agreement with those that are receiving the Lord Jesus today. Our kids did not just do this performance just to entertain us, but to share with us the story about how God became flesh. Jesus was born like this in a manger. God caused shepherds to come rejoice. God brought wise men to come worship. All levels of society, from the richest to the shepherds, which were some of the poorest in society, God gave an example. He came for all of us. Just join me in prayer today. Dear God in heaven, I believe in the miracle of Jesus being born of a virgin, and that He came to die for my sins. I believe Jesus is the Savior. And I confess Him now as my Lord and my Savior. God, wash away my sins. Make me a new person. And I choose to serve You all the days of my life. Thank You for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. The Bible says, all of heaven rejoices. Some of you saw those angels up here dancing a little bit. All of heaven rejoices at one person receiving the Savior. That's what the Scripture says. And so I believe heaven is rejoicing this morning because of decisions made. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Now, it's important, just like a baby that is born, you don't just throw a baby over in the corner and just ignore that baby, because the baby needs to be cared for. It needs to be fed. It needs to be changed. It needs to be washed. It needs all of this care. Well, when a person receives Jesus, they become like a baby. They become a new creation. They become born again, and you need to be cared for. And that's the reason for the church. Well, one of the reasons, praise God, is to be there to share what's happened in your life and to share the Scripture and to cause you to grow, cause you to mature, and cause you to get to the place you'll tell others about what God did for you. Amen. Amen. So it's important to get into a good church that'll teach you the Word of God. And so those that are watching by internet, you may be around somewhere else in the United States or another country. I believe God will direct you to a church that will teach you the Word of God and it'll cause you to grow. Praise God. Would you all stand up with me? We are going to prepare to dismiss our service. Again, thank you for coming and worshiping with us and celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we rejoice with all of heaven at those that are coming to know the Lord Jesus. And Father God, we as Americans are at a very critical time in our history. Lord God, we're divided more so probably than any other time. We ask, Lord God, that you would send a healing revival, that you would send, Lord God, a peace that passes all understanding. Lord God, that we would turn from our wicked ways as a nation and draw closer to you. Lord, the things we're seeing in the earth today and in America are judgment because we've turned our back on God. We kick God out of our schools. We kick God out of our government. And so many churches have kicked God out of their churches. But Lord God, we will remain faithful to the end. And we pray, Lord God, that you would send a healing revival and renewal and awakening unto God. The only answer to the things that we are facing is God Almighty in the Lord Jesus Christ. So, Lord God, we thank you that we don't look to the Democrats, the Republicans, the Independents. We don't look to the businesses. We don't look to anything to be our source or the answer, but we look to the Lord Jesus Christ because in his name is God saves, and we thank you that you save us. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Merry Christmas, everyone. We have some refreshments, I hear, right outside, right out this way. So please join us.
There's a peace I've come to know.